I'm from a large Polish Catholic family. I studied my master's degree in religion and theology and cultural theory. I think as a result of that, I've become more interested in spiritual things. The way that we interpret the world around us to construct spiritual meaning. In 2006, I had an accident in the mountains where I fell almost 30 meters, and I had what you would call a near-death experience, where I thought that I was going to make the transition from this life into the next stage of being. Since that experience, over the last 15 years, I've become interested in questions about the other forces that are at work beyond sort of material reality. My study of physics combined with my own near-death experience have made me attuned to this energetic, essential nature that lies beyond the material world. You know, if we imagine God as an energetic force that connects everything, let's not imagine God as a man who sits up in the sky on a throne. Let's imagine God as a sort of transcendent force that connects all of us, whose essence is fundamentally energetic, like ourselves and like everything else. I think that's really an interesting way for people to begin to reinterpret ancient forms of spirituality in a more modern way. So I think my interest in the Camino was really to experience these more ancient forms of spirituality in order to begin thinking about how these ancient symbols and these ancient representations could be reinterpreted now to the benefit of many people as we move forward in this stage of our cultural evolution. The work that we will do at CiTIUS will be to carry out research into virtual reality as a technology. What's particularly interesting about virtual reality, it's the closest experience that I've had to how it is to experience the world as energy. There's two major focuses on our work. The first one is to use virtual reality in order to simulate the physics of nanoscale molecular objects. Using virtual reality to develop environments that will allow scientists to better understand the world at this nanoscale level. And that's really important because molecules are objects that you can't see. The other application is using virtual reality to develop new perceptual experiences. Let's imagine virtual reality as a kind of artistic canvas where we can provide and develop experiences of matter as energy. And let's understand if we can develop experiences which can have, you know, positive sort of psychological impacts on people.
Mi nombre es David Glowacki. Yo soy investigador en ciencia computacional. Yo tengo un laboratorio que desarrolla tecnología de realidad virtual. Yo voy a incorporarme en el CiTIUS para desarrollar este campo de investigaciones.